Want applications that can live on-premises or in the cloud? Bring the flexibility of cloud computing inside your data center with the only server built from the cloud up.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to a new series of TechNet Radio discussions for IT managers and business decision makers entitled Understanding BYOD, where we showcase solutions and technologies supporting computing devices, choices in business. My name is Kevin Remde, and I'm a senior technology evangelist on the U.S. Developer and Platform Evangelism team at Microsoft, and I'm your TechNet Radio host today. Now, in today's discussion, we're going to be talking with Yuri Diogenes. He's a senior knowledge engineer at Data Center Devices and Enterprise Client Solutions Group about BYOD. Now, unless you're living under a rock these days, you know that BYOD stands for Bring Your Own Device. And more companies and IT organizations are hoping and trying to support their employee productivity with mobility and device choice by being those key factors and sometimes stumbling blocks. So Yuri's going to help us understand the benefits, the challenges, and the considerations around BYOD. Yuri, welcome.
Hey, Kevin. Thanks for having me again. After all the Cloud Innovator series, that was great to record with you. Now we are here today to talk a little bit more about BYOD, which is a very interesting subject, and it involves so many things that we're going to break in two parts.
Fantastic. So before we get into that topic, why don't you tell us a little bit more about who you are and what your role is at Microsoft?
So as you said, I'm a senior knowledge engineer. The group that I work is called the Solutions Group. The reason why is because we produce solutions based on Microsoft technology. Recently, we released an article regarding hybrid IT using Windows Azure. Which involve many technologies. So our team is responsible for putting different technologies and aggregating a document that presents you as a solution. So there are considerations, guidance, or solutions architecture diagrams that help not only IT pros, but architects to think through the process of design and implementing a solution. We are currently working a BYOD considerations guide that should be release next year.
Fantastic. Look forward to seeing that. And so while we're talking about it, and I did introduce it very briefly, but why don't you give us a good summary on the concept of BYOD?
Well, first of all, BYOD does not mean bring your own destruction, because people sometimes say that BYOD is evil, right? I mean, although a poor BYOD strategy can ultimately cause destruction in a company if not planned well, that's not the ultimate goal. If you step back for a second and you think about how users operate nowadays, they are well connected, and these users are at some point also information workers that bring their personal device to work and will love to be able to do some sort of task and activities at work using their device, because he is used to that device. He feels empowered to use that device and produce more with that device. There is an empathy. There is that whole customization on the device. So they don't want to just have email access, because nowadays it's so trivial that they want to use apps. They want to have access to data from the company. They want to produce. And that's where BYOD, it comes into it. They empower users to bring their own device in order to produce for the company.
Right. So if I'm, I have that, my preference for if it's Apple products or if it's Android-based phones or things like that, I mean, that's that desire to, since I chose that device, I paid for that device, but I know I've got connectivity, therefore, why can't you support me, IT organization that I work, for the company I work for,
correct,
in this use of my device to get my work done?
Exactly.
Is this something that my company should embrace? Is it something that we should really strive for?
Well, I think as I previously said, I said two key words. If you observe what I said, there are two important key words: Users are empowered and users are used with their device. So if you think, if you translate that to better productivity, that's for itself a reason to embrace BYOD, productivity. In other words, by embracing the BYOD, the company is enabling users to be more productive with their devices and the device that they choose to be the whole day connected, right? So they, as I said, they are used to that device. They will produce more because they have all the customizations that make them productive. It's a quite simple to understand, actually. Imagine that you have a car and you are an excellent driver and your car is well customized for your needs. All the components were just based on what you want. However, when you go to work and you have to drive the company's car, you have to spend some time to make those minor adjustments just to fit on your personal needs in order to get through the day, right? So those things will take some time, will delay you a bit. With the devices, it's the same thing. I mean, you carry your own device, you know exactly what you have on that device, you know the shortcuts, you know how to deal with the, even with the problems, you know how to work around the problems because it things that they happen every day with you and the device. So if the company think about the productivity that you have by leveraging users that are using those devices, they will have a better advantage by embracing rather than avoiding this model, because this model is there. I mean, either you have two choices, or you embrace it and you have users more productive, or you avoid and you're going to see users trying to breach the security of the company, trying to access something that they are not supposed to access just because you said, no, you are not supposed to bring the device. So they're always going to try to find breaches so that they can use the device, but they will do it, you know?
Yeah, for sure. Well, I mean, that's the thing, though, isn't it? I mean, it would be really easy to say, okay, you have a device you want to use. You are going to be able to use it here while you're at the office. You'll be able to use it while you're at home or at Starbucks or wherever. You can use and be mobile. And, of course, mobility being a very important topic that, most businesses, that's number one or number two of their priorities, is making their users more mobile. And certainly their own, having their own devices would help with that. So I could just say, sure, bring your own iPad. We'll give you full access to what you need from your personal device. Or is it more complex than that?
Well, unfortunately, it is more complex than that. It's not as transparent as you think, because companies must understand that with BYOD, they first need to assess their own business requirements, considerations, and restrictions. So there is no doubt that there are challenges with BYOD, mainly regarding device management and data protection. So to directly answer your question is more complex than that, for sure. You really need to think through a series of considerations that are fully correct with your business, are fully correlated with your business. One thing is important to mention, if BYOD, you can't use the approach of one size fits all. You must customize according to your business needs. So there are a lot of complexity on that rationale, and that's probably why some companies are postponing the embracement of this, or they are studying more how to do that.
And it is complex, not only for the point of view of IT and business and the types of users and the kinds of access they need, the kind of data that they need access to, their role, the different breakdown of the roles in the business. And then on the other side of it, you have the different choice in devices, all those different devices, different operating systems, different methods of connectivity. So you have complexity on both sides. Okay.
How are we going to support that?
Yeah. Now, is there anything else that my business needs to consider?
If companies are really decide to embrace BYOD, they should create a clear strategy based on their needs and start to raise questions such as which apps are we going to make it available for BYOD users? Because clearly it won't be everything, so they need to do the assessment and see which apps are going to be available. How to prevent data leakage while the data is at rest in the user's device, because the data can be at rest in the data center, the data can be in transit, and at rest in the user device. So how can I protect the data there? Should I encrypt? How can I encrypt? All devices will support encryption. Which devices will be supported? What about regulations? How that can influence the way users are storing data on their device? And you go on and on with these questions until you can cover all the possibilities that are correlated to your core business and requirements, and how BYOD can affect the overall business once you embrace that. So it's not just bring and use it. It's not plug and play. So it must be well planned before you implement.
Oh, yeah, and it can be a lot of work. It can be complex, but I think the next time we talk, we're probably going to be talking about some of those solutions. We kind of wanted to frame the discussion in our first part, and then in our second part, we're going to talk more about BYOD. In fact, why don't you let us know what we're going to be covering next time we talk?
Exactly. So next time that we talk, I think it's going to be a little bit more fun because we're going to go through some core scenarios of BYOD and how Windows Server 2012 R2 can assist you on that. There are some great capabilities in R2 that can definitely help you embrace BYOD in your company. Most of the core capabilities are available out of the box, so you don't need any third party or any other product on top of Windows to start performing some actions and implement some scenarios. Of course, when you think about BYOD, you think about device management as well. So with the device management, you have System Center, you have Windows Intune, but what I want to emphasize is core functionalities that you're going to leverage from the OS itself. This is what is more important, because the OS is enabling you to perform some actions. The solution as a whole, you will need the management layer, no doubt about that. But you have to see the value that the OS brings when it enables you to do a lot of stuff related to BYOD. So I won't go in details now, but it'll be very interesting for sure.
Yes, it will. I think I know some of those technologies you're talking about. I think is another little tease. I mean, there's certainly the ability to have a machine be granted some access in the domain without actually being domain joined. So I think
that's interesting. Imagine this is almost a paradigm shift, because for years and years since Windows NT, it was either workgroup or domain. Now we have something in between. That's awesome.
Yeah. Well, I'm definitely looking forward to that that conversation. We'll be doing that very soon. And do, folks, watch for that, because that should be very interesting as well. Before we close, do you have any other recommended resources for our viewers to direct them to?
Definitely. One of the places that I recommend you guys to go is technet.com/cloud. This is the place where our team store content, and as I said in the beginning, BYOD considerations guide is coming next month, and we're gonna publish this content there. My personal blog, aka.ms/yuridio, Uridio, is gonna redirect you to my personal blog, and recently I present at DFW IT Pro Group here in Dallas, and there is a presentation, PPT, there talking about some of the Windows Server 2012 R2 capabilities for BYOD. You can download directly from there. And last but not least, there is an aggregation of articles that I put together at the TechNet Wiki that you can access directly from aka.ms/BYODSguide.
All right. Well, we will make sure that those links are also on the page where you found this recording. So if you want to check back to your browser and look for the other links, those links should be there as well. Yuri, thank you so much for your time today.
Hey, Kevin, thank you very much for having me, and looking forward for the next episode.
Definitely. And we'll see you all next time soon for that next edition of TechNet Radio, Understanding BYOD.